A very good day to Dr. Ramney and my fellow classmates. Today I'm going to present about the successful entrepreneur Lim Goh Tong. So let us start.
So for the background, Lim Goh Tong was a Chinese-born Malaysian entrepreneur and also was a billionaire businessman. He was born on 16 April 1917 at Anxi, Fujian Province, China. He passed away on 23 October 2007. He was the founder of Genting Helen. He recognized for his visions and courage in converting Genting Helen from an explore hilltop into one of the world's most successful places. He was once the third richest man in Malaysia with a net worth estimated to be $4.2 billion, making him the 2004th richest person in the billionaire list compiled by Forbes. He had seven siblings and he was the fifth child. He had an elder brother, three elder sisters, and a younger sister and a younger brother. However, his elder brother was dead during he was 12 years old and his father passed away when he was 16. As the elder son in that time, he was forced to drop out of school and had to take over the heavy burden of feeding his family. At the age of 19, he left China and ventured to Malaysia in search of new opportunities and better place to live. Next is mindset. First one is open risk taker. He was an open risk taker, as we know that the idea of building a mountain resort was a big challenge when he told his idea to his friends and relatives and asked them to join with Genting Helen Resort project. All of them were not willing to join with this project because they thought that it was an impossible task and very risky. So without any help, he needed to fight by himself. In order to complete the role within 3 years, he and his team had to live in forests and caves, and he was also the first person who walked by sheep 24 hours a day during the week. During that time, he almost lost his own life many times throughout this project. The risk faced by Lim Goh Tong finally enabled him to become a successful entrepreneur with the emergence of a world-class tourist center of the Genting Helen Resort, which can attract foreign tourists. Next is visionary. When he was having dinner in Cameron Highlands, his mind suddenly popped up with the idea of building a mountain resort because of the atmosphere of fresh air and cold air of Cameron Highlands. He believed that people might attract with this mountain resort due to the hot weather of Malaysia, so he decided to set up a hill resort that near with Kuala Lumpur. Once he confirmed his vision, he held on to the last, even though the process was difficult. After a few years, he had achieved his visions. Genting opened its door for business on 8 May 1971. Lim Goh Tong made his dream come true and he has successfully developed Genting Helen Resort, which became a center for entertainment. The third one is network. Lim Goh Tong obtained his casino operations license because he built close relationship with the Prime Minister Tunku Abdul Rahman. Without visiting of Prime Minister Tunku Abdul Rahman to Genting Helen, he may not know how well the development of Genting Resort and brought a great contributions to tourism industry. Next is team-oriented. Lim Goh Tong shows the team-oriented in action development of Genting. On April 27, 1965, Lim Goh Tong established Genting Helen Berhad. He led a team of technicians and workers to start. The government later agreed to build a telecommunications tower halfway up the mountain for better reception, but with the condition of the road was completed in 3 years and promised to provide 900,000 subsidy. Since he has to complete it quickly, he met the construction team to work in two shifts around the clock, 7 days a week. This showed a good distribution of work. Next is innovation. As I said before, the idea of building a hilltop was first conceived when Lim Goh Tong was having a dinner in Cameron Highlands. So he decided to build a hilltop resort which is Genting Highland. Genting Highland is a cold hill station set amidst the cold mountain air and majestic 100 million years old rainforest. Just 45 minutes away from KL City, it offers indoor and outdoor theme park, an 18 hole golf course, a casino, and Malaysia's biggest strawberry farm, all of which are set amid a majestic 100 million years old rainforest. Genting Highlands is also perfect for adventure enthusiasts, as activities such as abseiling, indoor rock climbing, and flying fox activity are available. It is accessible by two different cable cars, Genting Skyway, which at its opening was the world's fastest, and Southeast Asia's longest gondola lift, and the newer Awana Skyway. Next is the casino. Lim Goh Tong's original vision for the Genting Resort was a highland retreat where the old and the young families could come to holiday. The idea of operating casino is during Tunku Abdul Rahman made his first trip to Genting Highland. He said, in order to help accelerate the development of Genting Highland, the government will consider promoting the application of Genting to operate a casino. So on 28 April 1969, Lim Goh Tong submitted his applications for a casino license to the government through the Tunku's private secretary. Later in afternoon, just 6 hours after Lim Goh Tong submitted his applications, came the good news that it had been approved. Thus, Genting Highland became the first and the only casino license holder in the country. Next is the assessment of entrepreneur opportunities. For the Genting Highland is the hot weather of Malaysia. Due to hot weather of Malaysia, more and more people would visit mountain resorts for relaxation and recreation. Malaysia is a tropical country. Sometimes the weather gets too hot until people wish to go far for a winter vacations. However, Genting Highland is the one of the best places for Malaysian people to escape from the summer heat. At the same time, they can save a lot of money from purchasing a costly flight ticket to a winter country. For the casino, there are no competitions in Malaysia. Genting is the first and the only casino license holder in Malaysia. After he heard government will consider promoting the application of Genting to operate a casino, Lim Goh Tong was decided immediately to upgrade the proposed Highlands Hotel of 33 rooms to 200 rooms. This is because he knew it would attract many people to come to casino because there was no casino in Malaysia. The 13th May incident happened soon after that. The government stated policy that no more casino license would be approved. So Genting Highland is the only casino license holder in Malaysia. Next is pathway adopted to entrepreneur venture by Lim Goh Tong. In 1951, Lim Goh Tong opened a construction company which called Kien Huat Private Limited. This company recognized as one of the leading construction companies after successfully completing many major projects. He also joined in Southern Bank, which is Penang's first local bank. In 1965, he set up a private company called Genting Highland Berhad. In 1971, first hotel was successfully completed and was then named Highlands Hotel, later renamed as Theme Park Hotel. This was followed by Genting Indoor Theme Park in 1992, Outdoor Theme Park in 1994, Genting Car System in 1997. From the resort activities in Genting Highlands, the Genting Group, led by the late Tan Sri Lim Goh Tong and his successor, Tan Sri Lim Goh Tay, have diversified from its initial hotel and resort activities to plantations since 1980, cruise operations since 1993, power generations and oil and gas explorations activities since 1996, and biotechnology research activities since 2006. Next is insightful. What I learned from Lim Goh Tong. First thing is, don't make language barrier as a limitation to succeed. Lim Goh Tong was came from China. He didn't know how to speak or write in English when he came to Malaysia. He spoke Hokkien in his native land, China, and after coming to Malaysia, he learned Bahasa Malaysia, Cantonese, and English. This language barrier didn't stop him to negotiate one of the biggest business contracts in the country. Second, never give up. Lim Goh Tong sees cross shapes from debt during the construction of the Genting project. Even he faced a lot of problems and almost lost his life, but he still continues his work, even he was injured. Third one is be creative. Just like Lim Goh Tong, he had the idea to develop a hilltop resort when he visited Cameron Highlands. The idea was very creative and people never thought about it. Besides, to develop the resort, he designed Genting to become a place suitable for a family trip. Next is constantly improve and reinvent. It is not good just creating a one-hit wonder and sitting back to relax. We need to think of the next move and what we can do to improve and outdo what we previously did. For example, first hotel. Highlands Hotel was completed in 1971. Since the opening of this hotel, Genting Highlands Resort has progressively grown from strength to strength. However, he didn't stop there. He keep built a lot of hotels and Genting Indoor Theme Park in 1992, Outdoor Theme Park in 1994, and Genting Skyway Cable Car System in 1997. That's all. Thank you.